Oracle Internet of Things Cloud Service securely connects all your devices to IoT Cloud Service, gathers valuable data from those services, analyzes and processes the data received in real time, and delivers the processed data to your enterprise applications or other integrated services. So how do we get started? First, we need to create a device model. Then, we create an IoT application that will address a specific business problem. After the IoT application is defined, we register the devices that are part of our IoT solution. Next, we install the Oracle IoT Cloud Service client libraries on each of our devices. Once our devices are successfully communicating data to the IoT Cloud Service, we can monitor and analyze the resulting data. Now let's step through those tasks. A device model specifies how incoming data from a device is structured. It also lets Oracle IoT Cloud Service know how to interact with that device. Devices can support multiple device models. If the device model we need isn't there, we can add it. Here, we use the temperature sensor device model. The URN serves as a unique ID. The temperature sensor device model defines 7 attributes, 2 actions, and 2 alert messages. A number of predefined system attributes are also provided. We can create more attributes, actions, and alerts if needed. Now that we have a device model, we're ready to create an IoT application. This application monitors energy usage from a variety of remote devices. A quick side note, in addition to creating custom applications, Oracle IoT Cloud Service includes pre-built applications that are ready to use and fully configurable. These applications allow you to monitor and track mobile assets in both indoor and outdoor locations. An asset monitoring application can report the current location of assets, detect key operational events such as malfunctions and preventative maintenance needs, and report unauthorized movement out of assigned work areas. But back to creating an IoT application. Our next step is to associate the IoT application to the temperature sensor device model we looked at earlier. Then, define the explorations that analyze and process the data sent by the devices using the temperature sensor device model. We can specify the device sources that we want to process in the exploration, adding useful metadata such as longitude and latitude. Next, create the exploration and indicate where the data is coming from, in this case, the exploration source we just defined. Once the exploration is created, simply publish it. Next, we integrate the IoT application with an existing enterprise application or other supported external services like BI Cloud Service, Mobile Cloud Service, JD Edwards IoT Orchestrator, or Storage Cloud Service. The integration allows processed data and alert messages to be sent out for further analysis or processing. We can refine the set of devices that we want our IoT application to use. The default is that all the registered devices that support the associated device models are included in the total devices count. We can filter the devices based on various criteria, such as name or manufacturer. Now that we're done defining the IoT application, the next step is to make sure that the devices included in the scope of this IoT application are registered with the IoT Cloud Service. We can register a single device or multiple batch devices using a CSV file. Let's register a single device. Activation ID, device ID, and activation secret values are present after registration. We need these values when we are connecting the device we just registered. Once the devices are registered, we're almost done. We only need to download, install, and configure the Oracle IoT Cloud Service client software on the registered device. As part of the configuration, we create device software that uses IoT Cloud Service device client libraries. This software needs to include information about the device models that the device supports, including the temperature sensor that we associated in the IoT application earlier. When we start the device software, it activates the device to start secure communication with our IoT cloud service instance. When the connection is established, we can monitor the activities using the application dashboard or from the IoT cloud service homepage. Thank you for watching. For more information on Oracle Cloud, visit cloud.oracle.com/IoT.